Hi everybody, I'm Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields, and today I want to talk about the difference between pink noise and white noise, because it's driving me crazy. No, not really, but I get a lot of inquiries almost weekly about this, these two terms, and people are really getting them confused and twisting them around on what they actually mean, and more importantly, what we as engineers use them for. So let's talk a little bit about it. Pink versus white noise. Pink noise is the noise that you use to EQ your equipment. We've all heard, well, you run pink noise through your equipment and you do your measurements and stuff like that, especially with EQ. Pink noise is very, very, very important. That's the noise that we use for our equipment. So some people get that right. Some people think white noise is the way to go. And I think here's for the confusion lies. And if we get some definitions and a little bit of science behind it, I think it'll be a lot clearer for all of us. What pink noise, and I think this will help us, pink noise is the energy in every octave. Okay, let me repeat that. Pink noise is the energy in every octave. White noise is the energy in every frequency. That's the major differences between the two noises, if you will. We perceive sound in octaves. So we perceive sound in pink noise, and people will say, well, pink noise is tailored to the frequency response of our ears. Well, not really true. Pink noise is the energy in every octave. We perceive sound in octave bands, and the physical structure of our ear, if you look at it closely, is designed to work with octave. The octave is how we hear sound. Our ear is constructed in such a way that it's kind of octave friendly. So we hear sound in terms of octaves. Inside that octave is pitch. You hear singers say, oh, he has good pitch, or she has good pitch. Well, that pitch is found inside the octave range of our hearing. If a high note jumps up an octave and a low note jumps up an octave, it's the same number of keys on the piano or the same number of frets on a guitar. The notes are the same. Sound producing activity or the notes to our ears is few bands, maybe five or six different bands of frequencies, but the number of frequencies is many. Okay, let's illustrate this point through example, and I think we're getting to the real core of the issue here, and through this illustration we'll get a really good handle on the difference between pink and white noise. From 400 cycles to 500 cycles, that's 100 hertz difference, okay? That's one octave. From 5K or 5,000 cycles through 10,000 cycles, that's 5,000 hertz, but it's still one octave. This is the key, right here. Look at this ratio. Each one of these frequencies is exponentially more in mathematical number than those. So we have more frequencies. So the relationship is the same, the octave relationship is the same, but look at the huge mathematical difference. So white noise has more energy from 5K to 10K than 400 to 500. So there's more energy because there's more frequencies. So for further clarification, we know that pink noise distributes energy the way we hear in octave bands. Pink noise, the energy is the same from 400 to 500 hertz as it is from 5K to 10K. Pink noise is the equal energy per octave. Where pink noise, it's all about pressure and energy in each octave. White noise is all about the individual frequencies in each octave. So you can see, hopefully, the difference here. And I'm really hopeful that this will clarify some of the things I've been hearing and some of the questions I've been getting. Thank you.